Hello everyone, this video is presented by Electronics Engineering Student Association, that is ELISA, from Balchand College of Engineering, Sangli. I am Komal Chandak, introducing you the basic concept of digital electronics, that is logic gates. In this video, we learn about logic gates. So question arises, what is the need of logic gate? Why we learn logic gate? The reason behind this is, the logic gates are the fundamental building block of digital system. In every electronic circuit, we use gate. Gate is an essential component in the field of electronics. Basically, gate is a logic circuit which consists one or more input signal, but only one output signal. Input and output of logic gate can occur only in two levels. These two levels are termed as high or low, on or off, or simply logic 1 and logic 0. So there is a three basic gates. The first one is AND gate. Here the input A and B are shown here and the output is like this. It is the symbolical representation for AND gate. The truth table for AND gate is here. Here the A, B are the input and this is the output. So the operation performed by AND gate, it is the multiplication of its input. So A equal to 0, B equal to 0, then output, that is A into B, we get as a 0. So, the actually gate is a IC, that is integrated circuit. So, IC number for AND gate is 7408. This IC contains 4 2 input AND gate. The practical connection for this IC is shown in here. It is a 14 pin IC with pin number 7 as a ground and pin number 14 as a VCC. And for input output combination, there is a remaining pins. If we want 3 input AND gate, then use 7411 IC, and for 4 input AND gate, use 7421 IC. Now basic gate OR. The logic symbol for OR gate is here. The truth table for OR gate is like this. The operation performed by OR gate, it is the addition of its input, that is output equal to input. Here A equal to 0, B equal to 0, then output, that is Y equal to A plus B, is it 0. So note that here A equal to 1, B equal to 1, then output is remain 1. In this digital, 1 plus 1 is 1. And IC number for OR gate is 7432. And input output combination for this is similar as the AND gate combination. The last basic gate is NOT gate. It is also called an inverter, because its output is the complement of input. The symbol for NOT gate is like this. Here, if A equal, we give input as a 0, then we get output as a 1. That is, in digital, we can say that if we give as a logic 0, then we obtain logic high. The IC number for NOT gate is 7404. It contains 6 inverters, as shown in this diagram. It is all about the basic gate. By using this, we can make any circuit. Now there is also two more important gate, that is NAND and NOR gate. This gate also called as universal gate, because either by using NAND or NOR, we can implement basic three gates, that is we have already seen, that is AND, OR and NOT gate. NAND gate, it is the combination of AND gate followed by the NOT gate. Its logic symbol is here. This bubble represent the NOT gate. The truth table for this is the complement of AND gate. The IC number for NAND gate is 7400. Now we look forward for NOR gate. Logic symbol for NOR gate is here. It is the combination of OR plus NOT equal to NOR, and it is the output of complement of OR gate. The IC number for NOR gate is 7402 here, and its input-output combination are same as we have already seen. The one important gate is XOR gate. It is also called as inequality detector. In many applications, we use this gate. It's called as inequality detector because it gives high output only when its input are different. Just look on this, its truth table. Here the input is 0, 0, then we get output 0, then input is 0 and 1, then output is 1, then input is give 1, 0, then output is 1. Here the inputs are different in these two conditions, so we get output 1, that is logic high. And in If the inputs are same, then we get logic low. The input output combination for this are seen in this diagram. The IC number for XOR gate is 7486. Now we see how actually this gate work by using Proteus software. In this software, we use logic state for input and logic probe for output. Here we use AND gate. This is input, that is 1 we give as for AND gate. Then what will be the output? It must be 1. So we can simulate now. So we get output 1. Now we change the input. If we change any input 0, then we get output 0. From this, we similarly we can, if we give both input 0, then we get output 0. And similarly for all gate, we can simulate and check the output in this way. This is all about logic gate. Now let's have a look on propagation delay of gate. A pulse through a gate takes certain amount of time to propagate from input to output. This interval of time is known as propagation delay of gate, and it is expressed as here. This is the formula for propagation delay. In this diagram, you see a two pulses, that is input pulse and this is the output pulse. As you know, the output is getting high if input is logic low. So at this point, input is changes from logic 0 to logic 1. So output must be changes from logic 1 to logic 0 at this point. But there is a some time delay. This time interval is called as propagation of gate. This is the propagation delay of NOT gate. Due to this, if at logic 0 the output is logic 1 and at logic 1 the output will get as logic 0. In this formula, the TPD is the propagation delay of gate. TPLH is the signal delay time when the output of goes from logic 0 to logic 1 state, that is logic 0 to logic 1 state. And TPHL is the signal delay when the output goes from logic 1 to logic 0 state. So it is all about logic gates and propagation delay. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe.